Hello students, myself Sapna Blara. In the last video, we have done theme, message and characters of the chapter Midnight Visitor. Today, I will tell you the summary of the chapter. Listen the video carefully because in the video also, you will get many answer of your questions. You can easily give answer or at least of 2 marks question you can easily give. So listen the video, watch the video very carefully. The story is short but intriguing. Intriguing means exciting. Insight into the life of a spy, which does not seem to be as glamorous as we generally see in movies. Like when you also seen movies of secret agents, the movies are showing the glamour part only. They are not showing the actual or reality of a secret agent's life. Because that may be dull or boring. And if the movie will be dull and boring, nobody will see. That's why they are showing the glamorous part only. But if you will imagine the life of actual secret agent, then only you will came to know about their life is so much risky, so much danger is there, suspense is there. Spy also may not be energetic or rough, but their life definitely is full of danger, suspense and excitement. Not all spies' life is energetic and rough. Not all spies are energetic, but definitely their life should be or must be in danger, suspense or excitement. It requires a very sharp mind to tackle the ever-changing situation because they never know what will be the next situation. They have to prepare for the situation because they know very well that the situation will change now and then. Then they have to prepare for the situations. Let's start our story. The meetings, the first scene starts with the meeting of Aucible with Fowler. Aucible meets Fowler and who is fascinated by spies and secretly related to their life. Fowler was very excited to meet Aucible because he wants to know about the life of a secret agent. Aucible was expecting the delivery of a sensitive document. And this is the important document, okay? That night, so he asked Fowler to be with him throughout the night. He know very well that a secret or very important document can come. That's why he told Fowler that you have to be with me throughout the night. So that you can also see the life of a secret agent, at least a night. Fowler was disappointed after meeting Aucible. That also I described many times. Why he was disappointed, that is also a main question. Because of his appearance. Appearance why? Because Aucible was a fat and chubby kind of guy. And he thought that a spy agent must be a tall, handsome kind of guy who should be alert and mannerism. Mannerism means slow. Aucible was fat, chubby and slow kind of person and he thought just different of it, just opposite of it. That's why Fowler was very disappointed. Fowler, when heard about sensitive document, agreed to stay with him, okay, so that he may be able to see some excitement in the night. When he met Aucible, then Fowler was not excited. But when he heard about that sensitive document will come, then he thought maybe some excitement he would see. Aucible and Fowler go to his room. Aucible's room was on the 6th floor of the French hotel. So they both went to the room of Aucible. Both are startled to see a young person. When they opened the door, they were surprised that a man was just standing in front of him and he was just pointing out a gun. Both are startled to see a young person staring at them with a pistol pointing at them. The third person is Max. Max was also a secret agent, a rival spy agent. He was a rival of Osebel. He is slim, active, and looks to be sharp like a fox. He was just like Fowler thought. And Osebel was just opposite of Fowler's imagination. He directs them to enter and lock the room. Who? Max directs them to enter and lock the room. As he was pointing out gun, that's why they have to follow the instruction. He threatens Osebel and wants him to hand over the sensitive document to him as soon as he received it later that night. He knew very well that till now Osebel did not get the document. But later on maybe he will get the document, then Max wanted that document, okay? When he was just instructed them, then reaction of Osebel was, what kind of reaction of Osebel? That you have to think. Osebel remains composed. He was not afraid of Max. He was not even getting nervous. But he was composed. Composed means calm and quiet and sits. Without worry, he starts to complain about the balcony window that he thought Max used to enter his room. He was just complaining about the balcony because he thought that Max also used that window to enter the room. He was creating a false story. He want to divert the mind of Max into another matter instead of that document. Okay, that's why he was creating false story. Max denies Osebel's worries and told he used a passkey. Passkey means master key. And told that he knew about balcony, he would have used that instead. Max told him that he did not use that balcony because he already had a master key that he used to open the room. And if he knew about the balcony, definitely he used that balcony to come into the room. He told this thing to Osebel. Osebel reiterates his concern about the balcony and his complaint to the management about a previous break in his room. Again, he complained about the balcony and he was complaining to the management also that one more person came from the balcony into his room. Then the situation changed. When he was just complaining about the management at that time, a sudden knock at the door. Osebel tells that it is police to check his safety before the document is delivered. He told this thing to Max that police is arriving and he just coming to check Osebel whether he was okay or not. Max got nervous. His face was black with anger. He was afraid also. He was nervous also. And he was worried also. He asked Osebel to send the police back. In the meantime, he will wait in the balcony. Just like the movies. He told him, Osebel, that you just send the police back till I am waiting for you in the balcony. But don't forget, I have a pistol and I was just pointing out the pistol in front of you. And just when he jumped out from the window, as you know that the room was on 6th floor, he jumped from the window and he just landed on the land. And he was died there. Then the reality revealed to Fowler. The person knocking was not police, but only a waiter who bought Osebel's drinks. Osebel knew that who was at the door. But Fowler did not know that he was just creating false stories here. Later on, he came to know that there was a waiter. Fowler is worried that Max will return from balcony. Because Fowler also don't know there was no balcony outside. and he thought that he this is that the at the door a waiter was there. Then he thought that Max will came again and he will shoot out them. But Osabel is still calm and tells the room had no balcony. And Max had jumped to his death from the 6th floor. These things revealed to Fowler. Fowler is relieved and impressed at the presence of mind of Osabel. Then he was relieved and impressed also with Osabel's presence of mind. He realized that the appearance can be deceiving. We should not go for the outer appearance of any person because appearance can be deceiving. Now I am telling the main points of the story. Osabel was a smart secret agent but did not look like one at all. Being short and very fat, Fowler was a young writer who wanted to write about Osabel, so spent an evening with him. When both of them returned to Osabel's 6th floor hotel room, another secret agent named Max was waiting for them with a gun so that he could take the important report on new missiles from Osabel. To ensure the reports their own safety, Osabel invented a story about his room's easy access through a balcony just below the window in his room. Actually, there was no balcony. Suddenly, there was a knocking on the door and Osabel pretended that it was the local police. When the knocking repeated, Max decided to wait in the balcony, which he thought existed, but there was no balcony, until the police went away. He stepped out of the window and fell to his death. When the door opened, a waiter came in with drinks with which Osabel had ordered to be delivered to his room when he had returned to the hotel. This thing revealed to Fowler later on. Now, I told you, you must write down the title also in your notebook. It is also very important. 2 marks question as well as 8 marks question will also come related to title. Why the title is appropriate? It's an act of spying are generally performed under the cover of midnight. You know very well the spy activity was generally happened at night. That's why the title is appropriate. The visitor also comes at midnight, and midnight which adds the element of surprise in the story and it becomes more interesting. You have also seen in many movies, any ghost movie or any mystery movie also happened generally in night, because the night or the dark also added suspense and excitement in the story. That's why again the matter is appropriate. Max's uninvited visit at midnight is sudden and shocking. This is relevant to this chapter. You can add why this is appropriate. Osabel caliber as a spy revealed because of the sudden arrival of midnight's visitor. He used his presence of mind and his alertness also revealed in front of Fowler at midnight when Max arrived there. That's why it is also an appropriate title for the story. Thanks. And now you will read the complete chapter. If you find any problem in this chapter, you will text me or call me. Otherwise, we will discuss your queries in live interaction also. Okay? Write down the title, listen the video carefully. Thank you.